I'm all for immigration. I think everybody has a right to come and live in this country, but I want them to do it legally.
I'm Canadian. We have our own immigration situation, but we seem to take a very positive approach towards the whole thing generally. We tend to be a little more conservative, I think, in terms of our politics and media approaches. But something that caught my eye the other day was watching vegetable pickers in the South screaming for Mexican labor now that they pretty much chased everybody out of the States. I wonder who's going to fill those jobs. Maybe a few Canadians go down there and pick some fruit in the warm Texas sun. I don't know if we'd be allowed.
I think that our immigration laws need to be steady, and they need to be done in a way that secures the immigrants in this country to be protected, as opposed to being swept out of the country, sent back home to possibly a country that they've never been in, and that they need as much protection as anybody that's living here, that they've always worked hard in this country.
What I have to say about that is that ever since the Mexican population has been moving into our country, jobs are becoming scarcer for American citizens. And I think the wise thing to do would be to document these workers and put them in work camps or someplace where they will quit stealing jobs from American citizens.
I think immigration is fine. I think everybody should be welcome, but I think they should all come in legally and learn English.
Immigration is it's a tough issue, and I feel like that there's a lot of people in this country who don't understand that everybody has dignity and that everybody deserves the right to a good life, and I just feel like there's a lot of change that needs to happen and a lot of reform.
Well, I think we desperately need reform. The problem is, as I see it, that the people who come here to work and to do things for American citizens don't get the kind of support that they need and tend to be the ones that get dumped on as soon as things start to go bad for the rest of us.
The U.S. on current immigration policy in 2011 is, I believe, unproductive, and the U.S. is taking a stance of being a fair weather friend to Latinos. I think we really need to emphasize business growth and development and provide a means and incentives for business startup. We've seen historically in U.S. Latin American history where Latinos were previously hoping for a Marshall Plan and they didn't receive the Marshall Plan as they did in Europe. And all the way through the Kennedy administration, which provided a substantive program but was deemed ineffective during Kennedy's era, only had marginal success. Whereas in the Nixon administration, we saw a lot of dirty wars and supportive dictatorships, which I believe is very undemocratic. I believe that the U.S. now has a current policy of extraditing people and forcing law enforcement into profiling people. People are very, very intimidated and outraged by the profiling. They are decent citizens and care for our country just as much as anyone else. And I believe the current immigration policy does more to bust local economies than help it. We don't see a lot of other people in the diversity of America going out and producing and doing farm labor, harvesting and so forth. And you know, there might be a few jobs where the mainstream of America might be affected, as in construction or so forth, but I believe that the U.S. immigration policy is more harmful than anything else.
Justo ni justificable que estén alentando a toda la gente así nomás, como realmente, como si fueran unos criminales. Y repito otra vez, ellos vinieron en busca de la vida, en busca de un mejor vivir para su familia, y resulta que lo están tratando mal. Su único pecado fue venir a trabajar, a ganar el sustento y el pan para sus hijos, buscar un bienestar para sus hijos que están en sus países. ¿Y cómo los están sacando? Amarrados como si fueran delincuentes. No todos son delincuentes. Se dijeron que solamente a los meros delincuentes tenían que sacar. Los que tenían ya delitos, antecedentes criminales. ¿Y qué? Están sacando a gente que en verdad no debe nada. Su único pecado fue venir aquí a buscar el pan de sus hijos, aquí a Estados Unidos. Aquí se dice que es un país de inmigrantes y realmente, usted, si conoce la historia, usted sabe quiénes fueron los que vivieron aquí en este país. ¿Quiénes fueron los que vinieron a invadir este territorio? ¿Quiénes fueron? ¿Se acuerda? ¿Quiénes fueron?
America needs to pass a reform immigration policy because, for example, my brother, he wants to go on to college, and what stops him is that he doesn't have papers to do so. So it would help him out if they pass this policy so that he can fulfill his goals in life.
Sí, como les digo, yo quisiera que la gente tuviera la oportunidad que yo tuve cuando yo vine a Estados Unidos. Yo vine el 85 y el 89 yo arreglé papeles por la amnistía. Yo quisiera pues que la más gente que viene ahorita o que está mucho tiempo aquí ilegal, el gobierno pues hiciera algo por ellos, ¿no? Algo de positivo, algo que los ayudara a tener una estadía bien aquí, ¿no? Eso es todo.
Es necesario que pasen las reformas porque aquí muchos comercios se están viendo afectados porque la gente no quiere gastar su dinero, lo envía para sus países porque les da miedo que si salen no saben si van a regresar a su casa.
My feelings on immigration are that if you have a lot of money, you come from a European country, it favors you, but if you come to help your family and get a low-paying job and just to better your quality of living, it doesn't work for you.
Well, we need the immigration reform because if we don't have workers, young workers in all the nation, when we can be more old, this country collapse the economy. So we need young people, new people for all towns in the United States.
Pues yo pienso de que debería de pasar la reforma migratoria porque como yo que tengo mis documentos aquí, hay muchos que los tienen y pagamos taxes y por la opción de que hay muchas personas que no los tienen, pues si ustedes se dieran cuenta, ellos pagaran también taxes y ustedes le dieran la oportunidad de tener documentos. Y no solo porque una persona no hace bien lo que tiene que hacer, no vamos a pagar a los demás la culpa. Pero yo pienso que esa opción de ustedes lo dejo a un criterio del presidente, de que él lo tiene en la mano de poderlo pasar.
I believe that an immigration reform is necessary because all the Hispanics that come to this country, most of the Hispanics that come to this country, come to work. They don't come to cause any violence, cause any mishap. They come because they want to succeed, get away from the miserable rates they receive in their countries. There's some people that come over here and they want to establish their life. They don't want to go back to their country because they like the style of living they have here. And to me, as an immigrant, when I was brought here when I was 2 years old, and I've lived in this country now, I'm a U.S. citizen, and I work. I actually own a business in Osceola, Iowa, and it's difficult for us to find employees that actually want to work hard, people that are actual U.S. citizens. And we're trying to find them, and we've gone through quite a bit, but we haven't been able to. So you got these guys coming over, and they're working for cheap labor, and they're working twice as much as U.S. citizens are, but at the same time, they're not receiving anything. And to me, if it's not a permanent reform, as such as people come and have permanent residency, it's okay. But if they do something like temporal visas or something like that way they could keep accounts on everything, whether they get in trouble, whether they buy something or not, that's a great thing for me, and that helps the economy.